Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the physics of sound, part three. Part one, we talked about level or strength, amplitude. Part two, we talked about frequency. This is going to be about propagation. Where does level frequency travel through, if you will? Well, we know that we have paths, and it's all about going through stuff, air, solids, liquids. Sound goes through all three. And the time it takes for it to do that is influenced by whether it's a gas, liquid, or a solid. So we've got to keep all that in mind. But we can forget about the other stuff because in acoustics, we're really talking about air and solids. Those are our two paths of propagation. That's what we have to deal with when we deal with sound. In our rooms, the treatment side of it, everything's moving through the air. We're talking about the pressure from the lower frequencies. We're talking about the reflections off all the walls, ceilings, and floors. So we have two tools, basically, at our disposal to treat the energy that goes through the air, that's propagated through the air. We have diffusion and absorption. Solids, that's our barrier, our noise. That's our shell of our studio or our room. And that's all about vibrations. Now, energy that travels through air versus energy that travels through solids, same kind of physics, same kind of science, but the key to understanding the difference between the two is in the overlap of the sciences. So energy that moves through air has a different signature to it than energy that moves through solids once it's in the medium. So our real goal in acoustics, when we're dealing with the transmission of noise, we're really dealing with the transmission of lowering the strength or the amplitude level of the frequency. So we get all three working together in the same medium, whether it's an air, whether it's solid, whether it's a gas, it doesn't matter. We're using all three of those variables to deal with it. And that's what's so complicated for people to understand, I think, with barrier technology is that, well, I'm just going to put up this material to stop this noise without really knowing about the property of the noise, the strength and the amplitude of it, and the frequency, and not knowing what the material is designed to do against that amplitude and frequency. And that's where the problems arise. And you'll spend all that time and money in building something, and you'll get in the room and you won't be able to hear what you want to hear inside the room, and you won't be able to isolate from the noise. And here's another problem with the barrier stuff with the solids. You can build something you think will stop the noise, and then when it doesn't, you may have to tear the whole thing out and start over because what you built may not match the frequency and level of the problem. So you can really shoot yourself in the foot in terms of labor and materials and budget if you don't do your measurements first and design your material, your solid material, to isolate the noise from correctly to match frequency and amplitude. So I hear a lot of times, well, people say, I'll put up some foam to stop the garbage truck. Won't work. Foam is a sound absorption technology, not a barrier technology. So always look at level frequency and what those two are moving through to give you an idea of what you should do for treatment. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.